Hello, this time I've decided to make a guide for the Warrior support pack, the Beastmaster. At the moment it looks like it's gonna be very good for raiding and is already very good when used in a group when doing dungeons. So what is a Beastmaster? It's basically a support that supports the group or even the whole raid with your unique cooldowns, and it's currently the only support at level 50 that's really gonna be worth using. It might be combined together with Oracle or Bard, but I'm not completely sure if that's gonna be the case. So what is the spec? The spec I'm using for Beastmaster, this is what I've come up with. I've not tested that many specs out, but this one looks really promising already. And how the spec plays is basically the same as the old Nightmare Tide Beastmaster. So if you know how the old Beastmaster in Nightmare Tide used to work, well, it's exactly the same. We just don't have that many soul points to spend into Paragon, but how it plays and how it works, it's remained exactly the same. So if you know how the 48 Beastmaster in Nightmare Tide used to work, this video is not for you. You know everything already, but for the new guys, I've decided to make this video to show you what buffs you are getting, how you should be using your abilities, what you need to track, what you don't need to track, and what the abilities do. So let's start by looking which buffs you get. As a Beastmaster, you get Bond of Alacrity, it increases speed on your group. You get Bond of Shelter, it increases resistances and armor. Then you get Call of Kinship, that's an AoE raid heal. You get Call of Stone, reduces damage by 5% on the group. You get Call of Savagery, it's 5% DPS increase on the group, really nice. Then you get Bond of Power, it increases main stat of every single guy in your party. Then you get Paragon buff, Way of the River, and Tempest buff, Enhanced Conductivity. And you also get Turn the Blade, which increases, it reduces global cooldown, and it increases number of abilities you can use at the start. And I'm always using Turn the Blade when I'm starting the fight, because it makes the debuffing and preparing your dots much faster, and at start you have to use cooldowns. It really helps. So now let's take a look which abilities you need to have on your bar if you wanna play it somewhat optimally. First is Tearing Slash, it's a dot finisher. You use that one when the old Tearing Slash you applied expired. Then you use Cutting Slash. Cutting Slash stacks 3 times and you need to make sure it never falls off the target. It means it has to be refreshed with like 2 or 3 seconds remaining. Then you have Enrage, Raid cooldown. And even when nobody in the group is gonna benefit from it because you get a debuff, it's still used because it increases damage of your pet. Then we get Command to Attack, it's similar as Flaring Power in Archon. Useful for many situations. Then we get a finisher, which is Brutal Strike. It's used whenever Tearing Slash is already on the target. Then I've made a Building Macro. It consists of abilities that will always give you attack points, and I can show you the macro here. These are the abilities I've put in that macro, and I'll link the macro, the builder macro, in the description of the video as well. Then we have survivability macro. It's basically raid cooldowns. It's Command to Stand Ground and Command to Recover. Those two abilities are unique raid cooldowns which increase survivability of your whole raid. They are used when there's a lot of damage being taken by the group. Command to Stand Ground and Command to Recover. Then you have Spotter's Call. This ability is used when you are the only support in the group. And then I have Fierce Strike on a separate button as well, because sometimes I have to use that instead of the building macro to purge the target, so I remove buffs from the mobs I'm attacking. And then I have Thread the Trees, which is a nice charge and can be useful for disconnects on some bosses. And that's it. Just a quick note, I've decided to spend 2 points into Purge, but you can get a spec without a Purge as well and spend other points in like Primal Fury to get more pet DPS. Or if you really wish, you can get Flinching Strike as well, which is an interrupt from Paragon, but I've decided not to get it for this spec. So now that we've covered macros, abilities, buffs that you're getting, it's time to buff up. And I'll tell you how the opening of the rotation for this spec is. Opener for the rotation is actually quite hard. You need to time your abilities properly. And how it works, it's like that. First you start with Spotter Skull, then you use Twin Cuts, then you use a finisher, which is Brutal Strike, and then it's time, it depends if the raid needs cooldowns, the DPS cooldowns already or not, but if you can wait another second, you can use One Cutting Slash before the cooldowns come as well, and then you use Enrage, you use Command to attack, you turn off, turn the blade buff, you use Cutting Slash to apply the third stack on the target, and then you use Tearing Slash and proceed with the usual rotation, which is Builder Macro and Finisher Macro, and you need to keep track of the abilities that are the dots that are about to fall off from the target and reapply them when necessary. So let's see the opening rotation first, and then we'll talk about the main rotation of the spec. So opening rotation, as I said, it's Spotter Skull, Twin Cuts, Cutting Slash, Enrage, Command to Attack, Finisher, Cutting Slash, you turn off, turn the blade, another one, and you use your finisher and proceed with the usual rotation. This is one of the best openers you can get, but the opener depends on the situation you are in really. Sometimes you have to do things differently, and it really depends. And now you can see on my screen which abilities I'm tracking. I'm basically tracking Tearing Slash, I have colors for that. Then I'm tracking Twin Cuts, but that's not really necessary because it's part of the spam macro anyway. And then I'm also tracking Cutting Slash, it's very important to track that one properly. If it falls off, it's gonna be a huge DPS loss. And after you've applied all your dots, you just proceed with the usual rotation. I'm also tracking Spotter Skull, but there are some situations in raids where you won't be tracking that because it's applied by another support. And you can see that my Cutting Slash was about to fall off, 1 second remaining, and I reapplied it. And then I just proceed with basically two button spam, which is the Builder Macro and Brutal Slash Finisher. The rotation is priority based, it's not set block, it just depends what has to be used on some certain situations and whatnot. And it's really powerful. You can see I'm doing around 1.1k DPS at the moment. And people are saying yes, that it's the best DPS pack for Warrior, single target one. It's not true, Paragon does more, it's just how supports work. And people who are claiming that it's the highest single target DPS for a Warrior on Rift Prime at the moment just have no clue how supports in group content work. But I'll leave this topic for another time. Let's focus on Beastmaster for now. So I'm at 1.1k at the moment. And all you need to do in this pack is basically pay a close attention on the three debuffs you have, which are Cutting Slash, Tearing Slash and Spotter Skull. Those abilities have to be refreshed instantly. Spotter Skull and Tearing Slash can be refreshed when they fall off, but Cutting Slash, you have to make sure that Cutting Slash never falls off the target. And for this spec, I prioritize crit power because the base crit value of the spec is really high. We can check how high it is. It's 35%, which is really good since no raids and there is no raid gear available yet. And you see that there are situations where all three debuffs are about to fall off, and it's always the most important thing to keep refreshing cutting slash. The other two abilities don't really matter all that much. And for the pet I'm using my Flappy Boy pet, it's the ranged pet, because if I use the melee pet is gonna taunt, and that's not what you want when you're doing group content. Okay, so we've seen the rotation now. I just wanted to point out another few things that this pack is only useful if you're doing group content and raid content. It's really bad for soloing because of how the opener works, because by the time you've applied all your 6 or 7 dots you have in the spec, target is gonna die already and you will do like really really low DPS. I don't recommend it for soloing, even though the tank pet is nice. And yeah, that's it. This pack is really not hard to play, it's basically the same as the old 48 Beastmaster from Nightmare Tide, and it just takes some practice to master how the dots work and when you should be reapplying them, and that's basically all. So thanks for watching.